What everyone was talking about is hold that thing down on the floor and stay on the bottom of the racetrack the short way around. Seems to be working so far for Kyle Fowler and Ty Dillon.
See, the yellow line is your best friend. I mean, that takes away a passing lane. As long as you stay down on that yellow line, you're going to have to go around me on the outside. So I don't have to look to my left very often.
Oh, oh, just saw a tire get broken
trouble.
Off.
Looked like something happened there.
The 94 of Brett Hudson turned around, slams into the wall. The tire came off just before he entered turn three, and we could see the outside lining of that coming off.
And listen, it's not unusual to have a tire problem on the left side because you run the air pressure so low. And sometimes those pressures are so low and the air pressure doesn't build up quick enough, it can damage the tire.
Brett Hudson down on the bottom of the racetrack. You'll see the left rear come off right there.
Yep. Just lost the tread.
Milk Aduna did a great job, the 63 car, giving him room and avoiding him.
Oh, and how about how close that was for Mariev Defoe that went by. Within inches of that car making its way up the racetrack.
There's Milka. She might have made a little contact. She slips by.
Look at her move up the racetrack.
Mark Thompson, fortunately, the 66 car was high enough and gave her some room. As you mentioned, Mariev Defoe barely getting by.
Great job. You just don't see many single car accidents here.
Great job by Brett Hudson. He almost saved that car, and there was absolutely nothing he could do with that casing gone off the left rear tire.
Yeah, we've got an interest. Chris Buescher, which you guys have seen race a lot over the last 2 years. He's finally 18. He's down here with the Rulo brothers and their Ford. And Jack Roush helps that program a lot. It's a Roush Fenway Ford. So, you know, like a lot of guys in this series, this is their first time at Daytona, and they're just out there trying to get some laps under their belt, make some laps, you know, watch the car.
No trouble. Problems on the racetrack. That's the 52. Gets turned around.
That's Tom Hesser. Looked like he had got run into from behind. Milk Aduna did a great job avoiding him. Another close call
Milka
for her.
Was right in the middle of that, but was able to avoid it. Great job on her part.
Yeah, that's great. That just a one-car incident.
I know. That's
a nice
that's
job.
The second one where we've had a car right in the middle of the pack get turned around, but with only a one-car incident.
But what a tough break for Tom Hesser. Yeah. Kenny Schrader's team, they're going to run full-time this year for the championship, and this is certainly not the way that they wanted to get started.
He was running 11th. Let's take a look at what happens.
He had to check up. The guys in front of him let up a little bit, and he got run into from behind.
Yeah, a little damage to the 41 of Ty Dillon. He made some contact.
Yeah, it looked like he got the left front fender just a little bit, so I'm sure they'll be down pit road.
See, there he is going around right now, but he did make contact with that left front fender.
You know, one thing that's helping all these drivers, Milka included, is there's so much grip that when you turn the wheel or when you make an evasive move, the car doesn't get sideways, doesn't get out of control. You're able to drive through some of these really tight incidences like we saw right there.
Yeah, a year ago, you know, you couldn't get slowed down. If you turn the wheel, you would slide and get all out of shape. So that's absolutely the truth.
Look at the damage to the right side of that as well as the left rear. After hitting the wall, a lot of damage for Tom Hesser. Not the way he wanted to start 2011.
Yeah, that's too bad for Tom.
If this race continues to go green, he may have to make a decision later on. He's probably good till he gets to lap 70 or so, 65 or 70 with the fuel he has.
So Trouble's out of turn four.
Big wreck.
That's Chad Hockenbrough in the 58. A lot of damage to that race car.
That car, I think it rolled over.
Tremendous amount of damage. I think the 30 of Terry Jones got a little piece of that. He's made his way to pit road.
The field all slowing coming off of turn number four. Incredible amount of damage to the front and rear of this 58 of Chad Hockenbrough. Let's take a look at what just took place.
This is coming off of turn number four.
Oh, he just gets sideways back there, and man, there she goes.
Here it is, upside down, actually hit the roof. It looked like on the wall.
Yeah, slammed it roof first into the wall.
He may have had a little bit of help from behind to get that thing sideways, and then when he got sideways, he tried to correct it, and then when it did, it just hooked and went straight into the outside wall.
Well, I wonder how much, you know, we talked about the sun in turn four. I wonder how much, if that had anything to do with it, because about where he is, is right where it's kind of blinded for a second.
Yeah, the car behind him may have bumped him a little bit from behind because, as you mentioned, so difficult to see with that sun.
That was Benny Chastain's onboard view of what just took place.
They're running wide open all the way around, and obviously the guys on the inside are doing it the short way.
The cars are more stable in the corners with the downforce and the banking than they are actually down the straightaway.
Lead pack working their way down the backstretch now, led by Bobby Gerhart. Oh, problems in the 10. That is Ed Papa.
Caution's out. Yellow.
It's going to be another big break there for Billy Gerhart.
Billy Gerhart's going to say, okay, that might help.
Might just take a sip of my drink now.
Ed Papa in the 10.
You can see back there all the rubber off the tire. So it definitely blew a tire.
Oh, yeah, right as the end
coming into the trial. Tire just explodes, and that tears the right rear quarter panel completely off the race car. And you know, he's not cheering because Ed Pompa had an accident. He's cheering because he needed a caution.
Yep, one man's bad luck is another man's good luck. He's got that 17 car behind him, and that car obviously either is going to wait till the last lap to make his move, or he's not going to make a move at all. He now can make it on fuel. Gerhart can. Oh, trouble!
Bobble
got
on
a 55. Tire down.
It looks
got
like the tire goes down. Also, the 25 has problems. That's Arpin in the 25 into the wall.
Milka didn't make it that time.
And this time we've got more crashing down below. The 23 of Nick Igdalski.
Mariev Dufault is the white car coming down the front straightaway. She was involved. The 15 car, Kyle Fowler, our outside pole sitter, is involved. There's Hal Martin, the 55 car right there.
68
Steve Blackburn.
Problems.
Benny Chastain, the 75 car right there, the drive to finish hunger car, also involved.
Actually, I said Milka didn't make it. That 75 car was the one I thought. Was Milka. I'm not sure. Did she make it through? Did we see her somewhere?
I think Milka. There's Milka right there.
Yeah, I think
she made contact with Steve Arpin.
I thought she was in it, but then I didn't see the car.
Yeah. Watch now. Watch the 55, the red car. Towards the right side. A little bit of puff
see
of smoke,
a little smoke
right
coming
there.
Out the right rear there.
Still see that.
It's almost like he may have a tire rub.
Tire rub.
I think that's what happened.
I think it's going to go down by the time he gets down to turn number 3. You see him on the outside of the 44, Frank Kimmel.
And Arpin sees this. He's right behind the 55.
They get down to turn number 3 and watch now.
There she's starting to go, and there she goes.
Looks like a right rear tire. And then Steve Arpin was moving to the inside to try to give him some more room, but Milka had already committed. Yeah. There was nothing she did wrong.
No room.
Nick Adalsi in a 23 also involved. There's John Ferrier, the 14. There's another view of it.
Coming out of turn 55 up against the wall, and the
Ryan Silas 11 also involved.
Yep, wreckage taking place even down in the grass. Like you mentioned, very difficult for the Venturini group.
There's two of them right here, the 55 and the 25, both cars from the Venturini stable, as well as Kyle Fowler is going to get involved. But you see, Milka was already on the bottom of Steve Arpin, and then Steve was just trying to move down to give Hal Martin some more room. And when he did, Milka was already there. Ty Dillon did a nice job avoiding that on the bottom side.
Well, when you have five cars in the field like Venturini did, you got good odds of winning. You also got good odds of wadding up five cars.
Getting caught up in something like this.
Your worst nightmare that more of your cars involved. Here's the second incident.
Mariev Dufault in the 12 trying to avoid gets hit right there.
Steve Blackburn comes down the hill.
Mariev almost had it made, and then a car came down and caught her. She was going by.
Riding along with Steve Arpin here.
He sees so that car. They still made it back there. They're wrecking behind you. Here, wrecking behind you. 55 cut in tire. That's what the smoke was. 25 went with them. We just lost our help here. Yellow is out. Big mess over there. Big mess. 55.
Oh, he knows right there. You hear the tire go. When that happens, he knows he's in trouble. And here comes the rest of the gang piling in.
I will take a look from the 75 of finish Chastain. There he is, you see him right in front of him.
Trying to slow down. He's on the brakes, but you just can't stop when you're going 190 miles an hour.
And it looks to be okay right here.
And then...
They're still running, Teddy. Come on, you need to stop.
There's Benny Chastain right there. He had committed to the bottom and then just couldn't get stopped. Made contact with Steve Blackburn in the 68 car. There's another view of the right rear tire going down. Then it finally exploded and put him in the outside wall. But by this time, the 25 of Arpin and the 63 of Duno were already together.
But that car coming down off the banking and a couple of cars back here, if they had just stopped, like right there, man, if you just got that thing woed up.
You're low. Back it down, come to the bottom. Nice and slow down. Easy.
She started to get back in the gas, thought she had it cleared, and then got smacked in the side.
She was doing everything right. She slowed down, really. She knew where she needed to go. Right when she got back in the gas, car came down and
came off the banking right into her.
You know, the first time she went down to the apron, I think she was going too fast, and it actually shot the car back up on the racetrack. She slowed down some more, got back down to the apron, looked like she was going to be okay till they came off the wall.
Spotter did a nice job too. I like the way he was talking her through it, but he didn't have any idea that car was going to come down the hill like that. So the problem